President Joe Biden is launching his, well, in his next bid for re-election, apparently taking to Truth Social to try and get to some more eyes, ears, and maybe even voters. Is it serious? We're going to find out. To truly reach non-traditional Democratic voters, candidates need to step out of their box, obviously. So this is what this first post was from the Biden-Harris HQ as they then signed up for One Truth Social. They even have the red check mark because it's Truth Social. They said, well, let's see how this goes. Converts, welcome. That's a pretty welcoming opening there. The Biden campaign announced this on the other awful right-wing site. Now it's called Twitter. I'm sorry, it's called X. Where they then posted this saying that they then jumped on Truth Social. Says, we just joined Truth Social, mostly because we thought it'd be very funny. Follow us there for truths and retruths, or whatever they call them. And I even linked to a Fox News article that was talking about the fact that they're over there. It's all fun and games and gags right now. We mentioned Truth Social specifically only for Donald Trump's truths and retruths out there. But apparently now we may have other things to go after. Here's some of the things that they've been posting right off the bat. This is where they might be changing my mind about how ridiculous this could be. Said Nikki Haley on Trump's suggestion that the chairman of the Joint Chiefs of Staff should be executed. Quoting her, I think it's irresponsible. They even have a video in case you didn't believe it. So you'd have to listen to her say it right there. There's another one. Trump's former chief of staff, John Kelly, confirms that Trump called American service members suckers and losers, refused to visit their graves, and that he didn't want to be seen with amputee veterans because, quote, it doesn't look good for me. Again, there's a video there too. So I'm sure lots of people are listening and watching these things, and maybe the converts are coming over and they're like, you know, I didn't know that about Donald Trump. You know, I didn't know that Nikki Haley was criticizing Donald Trump for saying these things. Maybe I'm all on Nikki Haley's side. Maybe they're actually converting people from MAGA over to maybe another Republican candidate. Enough of a change there. Here's the Biden campaign talking about Trump's record on protecting auto workers over on Truth Social as well, too. See that?
If I'm elected, you won't lose one plant. You'll have plants coming into this country. You're going to have jobs again. You won't lose one plant. I promise you that.
Operations at GM's Warren Transmission Plant end today.
All the people that are left inside know this is their last shift here. Those jobs have left Ohio. They're all coming back. They're all coming back.
A large American factory stopped production today after more than half a century. 1,600 workers at the General Motors plant in Lordstown, Ohio are affected by this.
It's hard to even fathom that I'm not going to be coming back tomorrow.
Well, that's some of the truth that have been truthed over there. And mostly folks have been interacting. Of course, they're probably very upset about this whole thing about how Biden is on Truth Social. That's supposed to be our place where we can spew all the racism that we want. One person did warn others about interacting with this particular page. Relentless Truth says, please stop engaging with this account. Whoever created it is trolling you and you're wasting precious energy commenting on their anti-Trump posts. By the way, why am I not shocked that Truth Social verified this account immediately? It literally fits none of the guidelines for receiving a check mark. More of the same. So he's very upset because, you know, other folks over on Twitter or X, when, you know, check marks are being tossed around or Elon came in and started changing all the narratives and approaches to how they even do normal things. And many libs and normal folks were like, yo, this is really destroying this site that I like to interact on. And they complained. And you know what folks said? Cry more, libs. So I guess the crying is taken over to Truth Social. By the way, how about those parameters for becoming verified on Truth Social? The Biden campaign meets the criteria for that red check because what you need is a profile picture, confirmation of contact information, and that you post content actively, and of course, that you're a notable individual. I think he's notable, even if you don't like him. It's just kind of one of those things. It's how this thing works. But I guess the bottom line, David, is cry more. It's just a joke, bro. And sometimes they drop you these nuggets of truth.
Well, I love that the Biden campaign has done this, and good for Truth Social that they're willing to play ball. Yeah. For some reason, I thought Truth Social, maybe it was Rumble. One of them is like going out of business or is losing money, whatever it is. This is great. For liberals and progressives, go on Truth Social and, you know, have at it. If you've got the time and you got the resources to troll people, have some fun.
This is what I wonder. This is where I think, not that I surprised myself, but I saw something useful potentially from this. They said it's just a gag. This should be fun. They start dropping all these videos and comments that are based in reality, which maybe aren't seen that much over there. And I said it before when I think Aaron Rodgers was talking about Travis Kelce and he's mad at him for doing a Pfizer commercial for the COVID shot. What's the objective in trying to convince people of anything? Is it you just want to say, I'm the smartest guy in the room, you dummies over there are taking that shot, you're going to turn to zombies at some point in the future, who knows when that's going to be, but you're going to turn to zombies. And what I want to do is help you. Do you want to help folks, or do you want to say how stupid they are? And this crosses to libs too. As many times libs will talk to the folks and you just call them dumb and stupid. And then there's not much of a conversion thought process. I hate debates. I hate political debates, you know, when they're not politicians. So if one pundit wants to debate another pundit, I don't get it. Why? Was someone being convinced? Is someone then going to go, you know what? I hadn't thought about that. I'm going to rethink my entire position on this subject now that you gave me those salient points of view. No, no one ever says that. But maybe if you're on Truth Social or any of these sites and you drop some actual information that leads to some people rethinking what they've seen as reality, maybe outside chance, they'll go, yeah, I love that guy, Trump, but I didn't know that. Maybe, although it starts as a gag, maybe it could lead to actual thought processes where people say, I never saw that because I've avoided it. I've plugged my ears, closed my eyes, and shook my head like Donald Trump tells me to do. And the time that I actually come across it and I have to fight against someone who's given me some small smidge of truth, maybe in the back of their brains, they start rethinking and go, I don't want to be that guy. I don't know. Maybe.
Or even maybe there's just one area of agreement. Maybe there's just one point, one salient point that people agree on when Joe Biden is posting in Truth Social and people realize, okay, I don't disagree with Joe Biden on everything. And then maybe it becomes, instead of hating Joe Biden, you know, 90% of him I think is terrible, 10% is good. Maybe in the Truth Social crowd, it becomes 75-25. And even though that's still crazy, you've made a little bit of a difference at the margins. And sometimes making a difference at the margins is all it takes to really start to change things.
You never know.
For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.